Today is Monday, the 29th week in ordinary time. It's also the celebration of the North American martyrs, those first Jesuits who came in the middle of the 17th century to serve here in the United States and in Canada. We may remember the names Jean de Brébeuf and his companions. So today we honor them, and we honor all those who have given their lives for the sake of the gospel. Our gospel today comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 12. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbiter?" And he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist in possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do, for I do not have space to store my harvest?" And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall say to myself, 'Now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, and be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you, and the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong? Thus will it be for the one who stores up treasures for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God.'" My friends, the Gospel of the Lord. You can't take it with you. I suppose that pretty well summarizes what Jesus is trying to tell us, but I think he's trying to tell us something much, much more. He was speaking to an audience which was essentially poor, but our gospel today, as it's being heard, it's being heard by people who are much more secure in their lives, people who are much more stable than the audience that Jesus was speaking to, and yet the words address us perhaps even more urgently than they address the people of his own time. In what consist riches is the question that Jesus asks us. What is it that ultimately is considered to be of value within our own relationship with the Lord? Certainly, it's not our physical possessions. In fact, to be rich is not so much a matter of how much we own, but perhaps the freedom that we have to live comfortably with little. We live in a consumerist society, and perhaps there's never been a generation that's enjoyed the number and the variety of physical gifts that we have received. And yet, if we ask ourselves truly, in what consists life, where does our happiness lie? I think most of us would recognize it isn't so much in our material possessions as it is in our relationships, the love we share with other people, the beauty that we enjoy, and also the peace of heart that we are so poor in these days. And so let us pray that today, that we may be guided by the Lord's Spirit to consider our relationship with wealth and to ask ourselves that important question, in what consists true riches?